first got interested in water polo after watching the 2016 Summer Olympics in Rio. I saw all the different movements and all the different strenuous activities that the water polo players had to go through, and thought that sounds like a good source of exercise, and decided to give it a try. Today I'm going to show you guys a few techniques I use to get in a great workout in a swimming pool, and hopefully you guys can use them as well to maybe start a little workout routine of your own. Now that we're in the pool, we need to talk about a few techniques and a few aspects that come into play when we're playing water polo. First of those is being able to tread water and being able to tread water efficiently. So there's a few ways we can practice being able to tread water for long periods of time. A good way starts right here at the side of the pool, where you can practice treading water on your own, and then when you get tired or feel like you need help, you can grab the side of the pool. At the weed pool here, they have different flotation devices that you can put on your body in order to keep you above water, but also giving your body a little bit of strain in order to practice those muscles needed to tread water. And for those of us who just want to play the game and aren't really concerned about learning how to tread water, the weed pool also offers a multitude of inner tubes we can use while we play the game. So up next, we're gonna go ahead and talk about swimming, which is especially important in this game. Unfortunately, when you play water polo, the ball doesn't always wanna come directly to you. So a lot of time spent playing this game is swimming to the ball in between shots and passes. So it's important that we're able to swim with good technique and with a good amount of velocity also. So there's a bunch of different strokes you can learn, such as the freestyle, the breaststroke, or the backstroke, and even the butterfly can come into play. So it's important to practice these, maybe in the deep end if you'd like, or the weed pool also has plenty of lanes you can practice and do plenty of different strokes on your own.
When it comes to shooting the ball, as many of us may have found out when we were younger, it's not easy to throw objects underwater or when our arm is submerged. So first and foremost, our arm needs to get completely out of the water. In order to do that, we need to propel ourselves upwards. My technique is of my own, and you can make your own renditions of it. But what I do is I use my legs to propel myself upward, as well as my non-throwing arm to push myself up on the water. And then throwing the ball is much like you throw baseball, arm back, shoulder bend, and throw the ball. I'll go ahead and show you a few examples of that.
Studies have shown that being in or around water is a great way to relieve stress. Oftentimes, we find ourselves in a slump when we're working out, doing the same curls, bench presses, and treadmill runs that we usually do. So the pool is a great place to come and mix things up and introduce a new workout into your routine. So I encourage you to take these techniques that I've brought to you today to your local pool, or here at the Reed Gymnasium, and most importantly, have some fun. Thanks for watching, guys.